Election Day is finally here, and as tensions rise, good manners will help us get through it just fine. So earlier, Sam spoke with etiquette expert Thomas Farley about proper behavior today and beyond. Let's all have a good look.
Thomas Farley, I feel like we need you in our lives now more than ever. So you're also known as Mr. Manners. Welcome to DBL. Okay, Thomas, it's finally election day. And I say finally because I think a lot of us are fatigued, right? It's been a very polarizing election. And I know for many of our viewers, it's gotten really personal because it's also put a strain on a lot of their relationships. What is the proper etiquette for family when it comes to today, when it comes to the election?
This is perhaps one of the most fractious issues any individual may encounter. So I'd say for family, forget the aha moments. Don't expect that there's going to be some magical eye-opening that happens because of a YouTube link that you send. So if you go into a conversation expecting a conversion, you're only going to be greatly disappointed. But chances are, if you're like most families, once you go down this path, it's a point of no return.
Many people, though, right now, of course, especially our viewers watching, they write in all the time. They're working from home. But we still have colleagues to deal with on a daily basis. What's the proper way to behave around those coworkers?
Many of your viewers may be working with people that they have never met in person because there have been new hires since the pandemic started. So don't make a terrible impression on someone by going all political on a Zoom call, on a conference call. It's going to set people off in the wrong direction thinking about you. There's a legitimate business purpose for speaking about it. That's one thing, but keep it as apolitical with your work colleagues as you possibly can.
Okay, so one thing that surprised even me is how different opinions could be within a friend group. It can get really dicey, putting it lightly. So how do you suggest we handle the election with our friends?
Yeah, so unlike our families and to a lesser extent, unlike our coworkers, our friends are people that we choose to have in our circle. And I advocate for not simply surrounding yourself with people who agree and think and talk and look exactly like you. So I say with the friends, appreciate and curate. So surround yourselves with people who do have differing viewpoints, but as long as you and your friends can have a considerate, measured conversation, because sometimes if we can't speak our own views and defend them, sometimes we don't even know the reason we have those viewpoints.
If I were a betting woman, I would bet that social media is the biggest issue and putting out your opinion on social media, right? Because it's so easy to state something when you have like the anonymity of being behind your own computer screen. You put something on there and then it takes off, it goes viral. How do we keep our cool when it comes to social media?
Certain platforms, I think, are better for this than others. So I think Twitter, perhaps, is the best place to put out a political view. I think Facebook generally tends to be better for family sharings and friendship connections. I think Instagram, better for sharing beautiful photos. So I think choose your platform wisely. What I don't like, Sam, are these people who say, I'm posting this, and if you don't like it, go ahead and unfriend me. You're doing me a favor by unfriending me. Everyone's entitled to their viewpoints, but social media, probably not the best place for sharing most of this.
Thomas Farley, thank you so much for chatting with us. And to our DBL Nation out there, if you want to learn more about etiquette and manners, especially right now where I feel like we all could benefit, make sure that you check out his podcast, What Manners Most. Thank you so much, and we'll be right back.
Thank you.